right. Please bear with me over the air noise or the fan noise. I'm discharging those batteries. In that 10 or 15 minute run, I only burned 28% of the battery. It was still at 73, 74%. Not bad. So, well, here's what it broke. That is smashed right into the side of the motor. That is essentially the output shaft, or I guess you'd call it the input shaft. I would call it a lay shaft, because I'm familiar with FGs, but the whole transmission case is broken. Kind of just spit it out. And the next step from here, well, and actually you can see it's got my spur gear covers all jacked up. So the next step from here is to tear this cover off and see what we got. Okay, this is dust. Give me just a second. Okay, I have not pulled this cover off yet. I just got the screws out of it. Oh, what a clusterfuck. I hate this thing. Please. Okay, so by the looks of stuff, got lots of bends and tweaks and twists. Let me see if I can get this stuff out. I think that there is the issue. This is binding on the motor. If I bent that motor shaft, I'm going to be fucking pissed. Because that's $250. Hang on. All right. Spur gear looks all right, which isn't really that big of a deal, but they're getting to be hard to find because nobody makes anything for these anymore except for the Chinese companies, and that's hostile. It's American stuff. Spacer's still intact. It's almost like a live feed engine, except for I'm not doing it with you guys. Well, actually, I am, but I'm just not doing it at the same time as you guys are watching. That is a no-go. All right, let me get the motor out. Oh, that was fun. when I put pinning gears on, I also put a little Loctite on the shaft, so, as well as the grub screw. So yeah, that was fun to get that off of there. But all right, that was 20 minutes. Good thing is, it appears that the motor shaft's still straight as Grizzly's dick, so we should be good there. Yay! All right, on with getting off this backing plate. Well, let's hope I can get these out of here. Everything's Loctited, and they aren't really wanting to budge. These are tips from Dave's Discount Motors, DDMs. I don't know. See if I can get it to focus on there. I haven't been overly impressed with them. Come on, you turd. Focus, you fuck. Anyway, they have a twist on the end of them from the impact. This is not a real heavy-duty impact. It's just a little Ryobi, you know, $60 impact, but... Oh, cool. I tried doing it with my hand driver, and... There's just no fucking way. Oh yeah, we blew the head of the screw out. Oh, that's wonderful. That one popped out. Had to get the hot wrench. Hopefully this works.
This is just shitty blue Loctite. I didn't even use hot lock or good Loctite. Yeah, we'll see.
Sorry, I didn't get the crack on camera, but she got hot. Sorry. You can see the end of my Allen's all discolored. My driver. I guess you can't really tell, but it is. We're gonna leave that right there to cool. Oh, of course that's fucking hot. It's aluminum. It's a heat sink. Surprisingly enough, I didn't discolor it. Put that up there on top of the vise. All right, more tear down. Oh man, when that blew, it popped that plate underneath the ESC. This plate right here is all bent to shit because that gear popped up. I wonder why the ESC was all loose and sloppy. Wow. All right, well, let me get to cracking. Hang on. There you go. Now you can see it. I hope the fan's not blowing a bunch. Yeah, I'll turn that fan off. This is supposed to be flat across right here. Awesome. I can beat that flat. That's no big deal. Yeah, it looks like I'm just taking off the top plate now. Actually, it looks like I'm going to end up having to tear the whole freaking car apart. So, what it looks like to me is the top of the transmission just popped. And when it popped, it kicked the... Ah, Dave, don't grab that shaft. It's still hot from when he took the... dumb shit. Well, anyway, it looks like when it popped, it just shifted gears and moved everything out. Let me tear it apart. All right, so after about 25 minutes of fucking around, I finally got this junk. Anyhow, that gear does not belong there. It's supposed to be down here. It's supposed to be down here. And something inside broke, I'm guessing a shaft or something, caused this to come up and push this out and wedge into the motor. And as far as the plate, it is a little bit bent. Which, that's no big deal. I've got a vise right there. I'll just beat it flat. But the problem is, whoa, my camera's upside down. Because I started filming upside down like a dumbass. But the problem is all of these junk-ass screws that came in that kit, every one of the heads has tripped out. So it's just been a huge pain in the cock. So I'll get all that junk straightened out. Get the transmission pulled out of it. I bet that was the clicking right there. When I was hearing it going click, click, click. Because there's just been teeth falling all over. And actually earlier, when I pulled the batteries out, there was a big chunk of broken tooth wedged underneath the battery. And I'm really glad that it didn't cut my lipo open. Okay. Oh, okay. I see what it is. Yeah, it started eating teeth. Typical shitty powdered metal gear, sintered metal, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, look at the teeth all just piled up in there. Why? Why are you focusing back here, you piece of shit? Fine, I'll put it there and then back the phone up.
Wow, still, you won't focus. Why? Why won't you focus? Oh my God, I'm about ready to just kick the shit out of somebody. I mean, it's not focusing at all. I've never seen it do this before. There, put the camera on the other way. Hang on, guys. And of course, I had a blob of grease on my thumb, so come on. And as soon as I went to hit pause, of course, I just smeared a bunch of butt oil all over my screen. I don't know. I can't get it to focus. I'm sorry. Just take my word for it. There's about 30 broken teeth piled up in there. Oh, now it's focusing. No, it's not. It's because I have the light on. But anyway. There seems to be a hole in my transmission. This here is still really tight. Jeez. And I don't have anything that resembles a pry bar in here. And I don't really want to pry up against the motor anyway. But I will. Yeah. Well, I don't know. It's all fucking clown shoes. Looks like I have to take that part of the motor mount off in order to get to it. But as you can see, I can't get to this back screw. Because I might be able to get by that zip tie. Hang on a second. Alright, so here's where we are. All the fucking teeth are laying in there. The transmission case is obviously split, broken, and the whole top of it pooped out. Now, this lay shaft, which I have to be careful how I grab this because this mount is hot. This lay shaft, as you can see, is thoroughly jammed in there. Yeah, I'll be able to get it out. It's no big deal, but it's just wedged itself. Most of the teeth are broken off of that. I guess it actually isn't as bad as I thought it was. The funny thing is, check out this diff. Is that a grease zerk? Oh no, it's just an access hole for putting lube in it. But well, it looks like new. Now the first time I spun it though, you could hear all the broken teeth and shit that are sitting right in front of it just. But so surprisingly enough, the center diff is okay. But the that gear you can't buy by itself unless you buy Chinese stuff. That gear you can't buy unless you buy Chinese stuff. So what I'm gonna do, unfortunately, is I'm gonna buy the Roven $155 transmission. Supposedly it has hardened gears throughout. It's all assembled and it's a three-piece, so it actually has screws that go in the back, so you can take four screws out, take the back of it off, and access your, I don't know exactly why you'd need to, but I'm not really thinking no either. I've got my mind elsewhere. If I hadn't have had that battery or that fan shroud on there, that would have torched that motor because it bent the piss out of that case. But the motor can feels okay. And it looks okay. I know you can't see anything through my fat ass hand, but the motor can looks okay. But you can definitely tell where it hit. So, well, there we go. That's what we need.
There we go.
Well, I guess I'll just go grocery shopping next week. Well, I'm really hoping I can replace all the weak links, and then the only thing that's left that'll break is going to be spurs and pinning gears, but I don't know. The good thing is, though, is I don't see any missing screws on my tires, so that's awesome. Oh, I'm drinking bottled Bud Light today because I felt like being fancy. Nah, they were on sale. So I guess I'm going to have me a couple of beers. It's Sunday night. I'm going to upload this for your viewing pleasure. Oh, broke that too. Good. Good. Now I have 2 hours worth of cleaning to do. But I guess it's a good time for me to go through and put all of my stainless steel screws that I bought. Yes. Yes, no more crappy steel screws. I don't run my shit in the water, but man, all I had to do was look at the X-Max and it started sweating. Or sweating, start rusting. I'm the one sweating. I'm fat, what can I say? Alright, well, this has been long enough. Thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate the comments. I mean, man, I had the running video uploaded. And, I mean, I thought it was still uploading. I didn't even have a chance to change the picture or anything, man. I already had 2 views and 2 thumbs. I'm like, holy crap. I didn't even know it was done loading yet. So, you guys sure are awesome. But this is what happens when your Baja only goes 11 miles an hour. According to that. Piece of shit. All right, guys. Well, to those that are hanging out, I sure appreciate you. And to those that don't, kiss my nuts.